Okay. I gotta stop. Oh, this is beautiful.
Today's video is something special. We are riding one of the coolest, gnarliest, steepest, epic trails that I've ridden in a while, and it's got some crazy features on it. It's called Diesel Wolf. And actually, you guys might be familiar with the train gap that comes at the end of this. You've probably seen Dylan Sheffer's classic photo. Kenny Smith was the one who originally built this train gap. So we're gonna check that out, as well as lots of other features on here. We've got an epic descent ahead of us, riding with the same crew as last week's video. Fellow YouTuber Nick from Van Can is here, and a few other friends.
So stoked to ride new stuff. It's always a good time.
The trail starts off a little bit flat and jank, but soon things start spicing up.
Whoa, bit my... Oh, yeah. Whoa.
That was bad luck.
Okay, that felt weird. It just felt weird on my neck.
Yeah, you got pulled forward really hard.
Yeah.
That was gnarly, dude.
Just like the latch of my helmet like choked me there.
Yeah, so you...
And then just landed and it was weird.
We're 20 feet in. Yeah, the carnage is already inside the trail.
Oh my goodness.
There are quite a lot of freshly fallen trees out here. It does look like we're one of the earlier groups to ride here this year.
Yo.
Oh, I jumped in.
Wow. This trail is starting off as a bit of a mess. Okay, let's try to ride Diesel Wolf. Oh, more trees. A few trees. Hey, this one's rideable. Oh, okay. These are not rideable. That's crazy.
Whoa, that one almost got me.
Limbo.
After we maneuvered our way through the tree traps, it looks like the trail was opening up. And we're about to encounter a feature that Nick wanted redemption on.
Added difficulty, it's not too shabby. There we go. Oh, this is sick. Was this where you broke your frame?
It is.
Oh.
We're here for redemption.
So last year, Nick from the channel Van Can broke his evil reckoning from this roll down. But now he's on his new Noli Chilcotin, so hopefully that's gonna hold up. This roll down is very steep, as you can see, almost straight down, and flattens out very quickly, so it's a bit tricky. And unfortunately, we've got this death branch staring us right in the face as we would finish, so we're gonna have to take care of this.
I just don't want it to like swing in my face.
Yeah, that's a good point.
I don't know what to do.
We were trying to break it by bending it far back enough, but that was proving to be pretty difficult. We managed to bend it all the way to just tuck it behind this tree.
Yeah.
Now that it's rideable, let's see if Nick's bike can handle this.
I'm just gonna go as slow as possible.
Yo.
Sounded good.
All right. Sick. That was smooth.
You got the compression really well there. It's actually fine.
Yeah?
Sick.
Well, that would be a success. He didn't break his frame or anything. If you're familiar with Nick's channel, you'd know that he actually has broken a lot of frames before. So at least this new bike is working quite well for him.
On the reckoning, I felt like, ka-tunk, snap.
Yeah.
But now I want to try this out.
Yeah, that looks pretty.
It's pretty much a free fall.
Yeah.
And then I just let go. And then just let go of the brakes because you're
yeah, pretty much. Okay, dropping in. Okay, that was hilarious. I was like not, I wasn't prepared for that. Like
backseated that one.
Yeah, wow.
That's scary.
Yeah, just like trying to roll up. That was awkward. Wow, that's hilarious.
Yeah, good job. Thanks, dude. That was sick.
So you can see partway down, I actually lifted the front wheel just a little bit as if I was dropping it, which is a bit of a weird decision. I'm just kind of more used to dropping things than rolling them, so I kind of am more comfortable with that. But in this case, it was a little bit weird. It resulted in me leaning too far back at the end.
Make me want to try it, man.
Well, we ended up inspiring two more to ride it.
Yeah.
Flat tire.
Oh shoot, no. You can hear it.
Well, that's pretty sweet. 4 out of 5 of us ended up hitting the feature, but there's a lot more to see on this trail, so let's continue. So Ryan's trying to pump up his front tire to proper air pressures, but for some reason there might have been some leak or it wasn't wanting to hold all the air he wanted, so he's gonna have to finish this run with a lower than preferred air pressure. And I hope his tire will hold air because the trail gets a lot steeper from this point forward.
No, I'll just follow Nick's line. Yo! That's sick. It's actually so sick. Oh, this is beautiful. I love it. Woohoo! That was sick. Oh, this is amazing. Like, look at all this line's potential. That's incredible.
That's what I remember about this, is just ribbons of slab with moss everywhere.
Oh, that's amazing, yeah. Whoa. Okay. Whoa. Whoa. That's sick. Yo, baby. Oh my goodness. My rear tire was like sliding a little bit. It's a bit off camber, it looks like. Oh shit. Wow. I gotta stop. I can't do that. Wow, that's so gnarly. Yo. All the potential for lines. This is the most beautiful thing ever. Nice. Yeah, I was going a little too fast down some of that. So good.
Like, I'm right behind you and you just come like,
feels like, I was like drifting, Tokyo drift.
At first I was pretty nervous because I thought you were going to slide, but then you caught.
Yeah.
And then you got to the main line and you were cooking.
I felt like I had enough control, but.
Yeah, damn, lots of brakes.
Not quite. Sweet.
You got it though, man. That was
so
sick.
Good.
That's a really hard move.
That is difficult. Off camber stuff is a bit sketch. Yeah.
It wasn't a drop.
I just dropped it.
And coming up here, we've got one of the sketchiest drops I've ever seen. It may not be that big, but it's very tricky and janky.
Oh, cool. Is it, can you do it though?
It's fine, but it's so good.
Oh, it's so sketch.
It's so close.
It's just coming into it, that's the worst.
Such a bad landing. You're so close to the tree.
Frick.
You have to do a wiggle as you take
off. Oh my goodness.
It's f***ed up, right?
Let me just do another run and just see if it will work or
I'd
not.
I'd be amazed if you ride with
it. It's all about just getting the run in smooth, that's it. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Well, that doesn't work. I would thought that over this rock would be nice because it's straight, but no. You have to go on this side. Okay.
Getting a good run in still doesn't change the fact that there's a tree just on the right that my handlebars will hit if I don't wiggle out of the way. The combination of everything together is what makes this very tricky. The boys were saying they've never seen anyone hit this drop before.
Hmm, yeah, that might help.
Maybe if we fill in that straight line with some rocks, that could work. But I'm interested in trying that right line, though.
Okay, dropping in. Oh, sh**, yes. Oh, my freaking goodness. That was so sick. That was sketch.
That's hilarious.
That was the sketchiest drop. That was actually the sketchiest freaking drop ever.
Oh my freaking goodness. That was so sick.
That was Jankville.
That was awesome.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. That is the jankiest freaking thing.
That's the craziest drop I think I've ever seen anybody hit for janky back there. Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
The run in, the close tree, the landing, the run out, like it's all mess.
Perhaps it's all the North Shore riding I've been doing more lately that's been priming me for goofball stunts like this. The drop isn't actually that big, maybe 5 or 6 feet.
Yeah, crank push, and then I was like, and then.
A little twist.
Thanks, dude. But you know what? The landing, like the runout, it's super easy to stop. No problem. Because it's very soft. So I had grip afterwards.
Yeah.
You probably, like, seeing on camera, like, you probably can't tell, like, how weird it is. Just by, like, feeling it. That's how you know. Yeah.
So weird.
Yeah, you wiggled into some style.
Yeah.
I'm feeling really good after hitting that. But we've still got more trail to ride, and it gets pretty rowdy. And we still have to see that train gap at the end.
Whoa! Some of this I'm actually like wishing I had my elbow pads on. Cause that was like, I was getting a bit nervous. Nice. What a trail. My goodness. What?
Oh yeah.
All right. Whoa, what the heck? Oh, that wasn't too bad. Whoa! Whoa, yes. Sick. So cool. Oh man, what the heck?
This was actually the most epic day riding I've had all year so far. I think I have to put Diesel Wolf as one of my top 10 favorite trails. And you know, I think I'm getting better at these steep rock slabs now. And it feels pretty satisfying having hit some of those more advanced, crazy features. And by the end, we get to what would be the cherry on top of this whole trail.
I think this is where the train gap is. Oh, sick. Oh, there's no lip though. It's all gone. There's no train gap right now. Sweet.
Long gap though, eh?
Yeah, it's a good size.
It's my first time seeing it in person. The run-in actually is pretty nice, and so is the landing. It looks pretty doable, honestly.
Would you send it, Jordan?
I would like to do it, yeah. I would, like I think so. There. It's a great landing, I do like the landing.
Too bad.
As far as big jumps, yeah. This one's got like a lot of good going for it. Good run in.
It's like 40.
Good run out.
Make sure you guys check out last week's video where we rode PhD on the same mountain. We rode that just before Diesel Wolf. Or if you like bike park riding, check out my Whistler opening weekend video. Where do you think I should go riding next? Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks everyone, and we'll see you guys next time.